All right, we are back. I guess this is episode two. it didn't do great at ending it exactly at the end of the mission, but whatever. I feel like I'm doing okay with commentating. I'm not really sure how good or bad I am with it, but it's Warthog time. It's like. So I guess there aren't really. Also, like, still working out with the volume. I'm not really sure how good that is.
Woo-hoo-hoo!
Because they don't really tell you where to go. Checked it on original graphics. Oh yeah. Huh. Wow. They really took some liberties with the gear and the time of day and stuff like that. Especially the soldier, like, wow. So, alright. I have no idea where I'm going. A lot of video games going on the train.
Survivors will probably stick close to their emergency beacons. We need to find where the lifeboats landed.
Okay, there are some HUD helpers here and there. Still isn't as hand-holdy as you mean, but so.
This cave is not a natural formation. Someone built it, so it must lead somewhere. I've hacked into the Covenant battle network. They're actually broadcasting tactical data on unencrypted channels. We should show them who they're dealing with. Master Chief, I'm going to use your suit's transcom system to monitor their chatter.
I wouldn't say that this is the best handling vehicle I've ever used in games. Okay, nice, nice.
Oh!
Did it kill him? Okay, now we're good. Oh, I guess we flip it. Looks like maybe they anticipated that it handles like a wet sponge.
Lower it!
I definitely came from that direction. Okay. Doing really well so far, I think. Very classic low poly 3D with the not a ton of lighting, but that's on charm. A little like kind of blue lighting with a little bit of I guess I can't.
Yikes!
Okay, I'm gonna deal with this myself. Alright, just sprint. Good old fashioned melee. I can't remember how goofy these are. They're just like kind of have a running around animation and like they yell in a kind of goofy way, but I guess they're not supposed to be very threatening.
There must be some mechanism to
cross this chasm. Shield, is it?
Look for a control panel or switch.
Check this out. Whoa. Yeah, it just kind of has a different hits different when you can see stuff in there versus this kind of nice atmospheric. Like, it feels more imposing this way for sure. Yeah, can definitely see why a lot of fans do not enjoy the remastered graphics. I mean, there's definitely a lot of low poly tricks they're using here. This is not a particularly fancy lighting engine from what I can tell. I mean, these are probably mostly textures. A little bit of extra lighting to make them be luminescent, but, I mean, yeah. And still, I mean, for a 20-year-old game, 2001. I mean, even in 2007, when I was working in mobile games and stuff, we didn't have lighting engines. Yeah, we didn't have lighting engines. I mean, all these are just textures baked in. Same thing with these things right here. These are probably not real shadows. They're probably baked in. It's just a little bit more artistry in games like that, for sure. That's why that's why I think those things age a little better than this stuff. Like, it's just way too much. You can see way too much detail. They took a lot of liberties. They just added a bunch of stuff that just isn't there. Like, it's one thing to look at a light like that. Like, it's kind of weird. Like, in a lot of ways, these lights got less detailed. So, yeah, I can definitely see. Let's see, I guess I... Brent would be real nice right about now, but I guess that wasn't a thing in 2001. You can only invent so many FPS staples. I guess their big contribution was like regenerating health or something like that, which I don't think... I mean, obviously Call of Duty really popularized it, but I think earlier on, like in the, you know, when we were working on like 3D Realm stuff, it was a lot of like, you always picked up. I should get my Warthog. Hopefully my dude survived. I didn't see him in our firefight. Does he just hang around with the vehicle? How does that work? Oh, yeah, we're just chilling. Okay. Can I, like, not drive? Like, what happens if I get in the passenger seat? Does he drive? Guess not. Okay. It's a single-player campaign, but interesting. Maybe that's more of, like, a holdover for multiplayer.
New traffic on the Covenant battle map. A lot more crew made it off the Autumn than I had predicted. The captain really gave them hell. If we can find Captain Keyes and the other survivors, we have a chance to coordinate an effective resistance.
It's like kind of open world, but I mean, it's still gonna have to go through like a pretty strict pathway so far. Well, that still looks real nice. Dude, don't want to double check here. It's kind of cool that he does that when you do a jump, I think. I've only done it twice, but it seems to be consistently triggered by doing like a sweet jump.
Lifeboat detected. No sign of survivors.
This lifeboat is trapped, Chief. There are weapons and supplies, but no bodies.
Just the blue things are.
Hiding in the hills above the structure.
There we go.
Got it!
Hopefully you didn't see the fucking fire.
Target down! Good one!
How long these guys would take to kill me if I just let them shoot me? They don't seem very threatening. Maybe it's like a numbers thing or not.
What the? There it is! Here comes more!
Oh, I'm gonna stop here. I don't get him.
Wow!
Nice dive. Okay. Okay. Are you fighting something, or...? Use my radar more. Do I get like more dudes if I saddle up here now?
You're a sight for sore eyes, Chief. You're in a bad way. You've got wounded here.
Oh, nice. He does jump in.
Let's do it! Ooh.
Sounds bad. I'm sure it's fine. See any health for the actual Warthog?
Poor Neo.
Dudes are like elites or something? I'm warming up. Or maybe the shield is like, it shows your health or something? The shield's health. Maybe that's why it turns yellow.
You, Echo 419. We have colors. Survivors and need immediate dust off.
Colors
Roger, Cortana. On my way. I've spotted additional lifeboats in your area.
Yeah.
One near a rock slide. And another near the cliff
I
edge.
Guess my health's pretty low, but I have
to hard
shield,
to see from my altitude, but it looks like there are more survivors. Acknowledged. We're on our way.
Oh yeah? There isn't. First time I've actually, like, air quotes, needed health. Came from that direction, I think. This is, like, sort of open world, but there's not, like, a whole lot of ways to go. No. checkpoint. This is the right way. There we
survivors
go.
Survivors detected. Marines are concealed in those rocks.
Like that! More over here! I see them! No stopping me! How'd that feel?
That was bad shit.
What did the sniper do like that?
Daddy now!
I also mentioned a compulsive reloader.
Whoa! Over here!
Kilmord?
Okay. Roger that!
Just kidding, maybe not.
Look, a Mark V!
Doesn't seem any better with the yellow versus the blue. Maybe there's help, maybe? Can't be. Let's shoot that one. Didn't change caliber. Skinnier guys, I guess. Maybe they're like daintier or something, so they need shields. The dialogue's kind of campy and amazing. Makes it a little harder to take him seriously. Whoa. All my dudes die? Hopefully I'm not held accountable for keeping all of them alive. Got the grenades yet. See how that dodge can get annoying on higher difficulties, or maybe when the AI gets a little better in later games.
Whoa!
But there's still a dude here. I guess he took one punch, or two punches, instead of one. This guy's kind of...
Echo 419 to Cortana. Foehammer's on station and ready for another pickup.
Affirmative, Foehammer. We're ready for dust-off. Approach when ready. We're going to look for the last lifeboat, Echo 419.
Still got my sniper dude still. Oh, it's numbers. No, it's not the real Russian. I've only flipped this thing over once. This looks the same.
Warning. I picked up reports that the Covenant has located and secured the Pillar of Autumn's crash site. The good news is the captain is still alive. The bad news is that the Covenant have captured the entire surviving command code. Let's hurry and find the final lifeboat so we can link up with the rest of the survivors.
So it's overworld enough that it lets me go around in circles.
Oh yeah! They're everywhere!
Oh, this way. Is it some way I guess? I just didn't carry it.
Last lifeboat is near the cliff edge.
Oh. I guess if you're not smart enough, it eventually tells you where to go. It's kind of cool, it doesn't immediately tell you, but...
Nice one!
Oh. Some good driving on my part. Okay. Just wait for them to get back
in. Let's roll!
I don't know if Master Heater is supposed to be trained at good at driving. He's too good at being a soldier, who knows.
Oh yay!
A little slower over here so we don't flip over. I'll take it. I'm gonna go this way. Let's see where we are. I get it, it's because it's got like branching paths if they're going in any direction.
Maybe
just gotta do all three of them, I guess.
Let's check it out.
Whoa!
Right in here. Glad I picked up the sniper dude, he's pretty fun. So. Oh, that's bad.
Incoming!
That's embarrassing. Well, at least it gives you a pretty big checkpoint. Okay, good to know you can drift right off.
Right on.
Learned my lesson at all.
More of them!
There we go. Oh, okay. Those guys can just Well, as promised, I am dying a lot. It's getting a little too gunk, I guess I started. Maybe it's starting to get more serious. I gotta heal up.
Here comes more! Whoa!
I wonder if those are the same grenades I have. We're kind of surrounded.
More over here. Roger that.
There
it is. Let's do it.
It'll be fine. Can I like bounce a grenade? Oh, pretty cool. Okay, but I can kill myself. Cool, cool. Okay, we're in the limits.
Whoa!
The blood kills me. Shield's pretty effective against
more where that came from. Yeah, open it. Fire.
Just gonna turn all of them back up there.
I'm on
yeah,
it.
Throw a grenade up. Deaths for one mission already. Okay. Oh. Oh, that's a guy I was not
Roger
supposed
that.
To shoot. Whoops.
Marines! Oh, assemble for evac! Pronto!
I mean, the game just didn't really yell at me. But let me shoot him. I do feel bad about that, though.
Do you see him? Good one!
Yeah, cool looking.
That's the last of them.
Check.
Roger that.
Yep.
I'm on my
Jeez.
Way.
This is so much detail.
New traffic on the Covenant Battlenet. I found
this
Captain
like...
Keyes. He's being held on a Covenant cruiser. The Truth and Reconciliation.
Yeah,
a ship
like,
I disabled
even, like,
before we abandoned the Autumn.
When you're remaking something, why wouldn't you follow the similar
the truth
symbology?
And reconciliation
like,
touched down on a desert plateau roughly 300 kilometers.
Some of these things don't even follow the same patterns. It's very interesting. Like, the intention here was clearly different. So, yeah, I can... It still looks nice. I mean, don't get me wrong. They really spent a lot of extra time doing this. Like, this took a lot of effort to redo these textures this way. But
there's our ride.
They
get aboard and let's get out of here.
Come on.
Welcome aboard,
look at the textures.
Chief. Ready for dust off.
Okay. They leave without me? Master Chief. I'll take my Warthog clothes with me. Maybe not drive off the cliff. Drive up the button. I can't believe that bit. Okay. I'm gonna drive up. Alright, that was a...
We should move out, Lieutenant. And then open world section.
Kind of a little meandering, but definitely pretty fun. Doesn't really hold your hand too much. All things considered, only a couple embarrassing deaths that could have been avoided by a more skilled player. So yeah, that'll do it for this episode.
The enemy has captured Captain Keyes and are holding him aboard one of their cruisers.
To be watching later.
The truth and reconciliation.